Hi, I'm Bethany, and I run workathomefaq.com, where I answer your questions about working from home, self-employment, and avoiding scams. So today on Work at Home Wednesday, well, we're not going to be talking about working at home. We're going to talk about just a random way that you can make extra income. Today, we're going to focus on elections and how you can earn extra income as a poll worker. So as you know, hopefully you know, in the United States, our November 3rd election is coming up. This is the general election, the presidential election, where we're going to vote on our next president. Now, because of COVID, we are facing a poll worker shortage nationwide. Poll workers generally are over the age of 50, 60. They're in the more vulnerable category for getting COVID. So a lot of them are choosing to stay home because they don't want to be around a whole bunch of people. Can't say that I blame them. So other people are needed. If you are a healthy person and you want to go and make some extra money, you may be able to get a job as a poll worker. Now, I am in Washington State, and Washington State is actually 100% vote by mail. However, that doesn't mean that they don't need temporary election workers. I personally have worked for King County Elections. I've done it for like 4 or 5 cycles of elections at this point. I love working at King County Elections. It's a lot of fun. And it's really kind of cool just to be a part of democracy in action. So what you may do as an election worker, you may go in and work at the phone bank, which is so much fun. It's where you're answering questions. It could be general questions about the election, about voting in general. People may need to update their addresses. They may need to get replacement ballots. It could be anything like that, working in the phone bank. You could be doing just general office work, like data entry work, proofreading, voter pamphlets, anything like that. You could work at the ACV, that's the Accessible Voting Center. Hey, that's the AVC, not the ACV. Okay, so it's the AVC. So those are centers that are set up, because again, we don't have polling places in Washington State. But those are set up with voting machines to help folks who are hearing impaired or visually impaired. Maybe they can't read or see the paper ballot. So they need to come in and have an accessible ballot for them, to kind of work on. And I've worked at the AVCs as well. So you can come in. And also when people like lose their ballots, I did have one guy one time, it was so funny. He came in, he was so embarrassed. He's like, actually, yes, my dog ate my ballot. It happens. So people come in, and if they don't have a ballot, we can get them a replacement ballot, or we can just have them vote right there on the machine. So that's available as well. Now, if you're bilingual, you may be needed to help with creating posters, proofreading, pamphlets, anything like that. For me personally, one election cycle, I got to use my voiceover skills and voice the audio ballots for the visually impaired. So for the folks who couldn't read the ballot or didn't have the braille, they could put on their little headphones and they heard me check one for the Democratic candidate, you know, that type of thing. That was kind of fun. So there's a whole bunch of different work that you can do when you're working as a temporary election worker. Now, many positions are paid. Sometimes people think, well, if you're working at the polls, it's a volunteer position. That's not necessarily true. In King County, they're actually unionized, so we got a really decent wage. And in some states, you can be as young as 16 to go ahead and get started. Now, of course, because this is government work, you do have hoops that you need to jump through. You may need to go through a background check, a credit screening, something like that, just to make sure that, you know, you are a good upstanding citizen, because you are going to be handling people's sensitive information. Now, you can get started just by calling up your local election office. Just, you know, Google your county and election office and contact them and see if they're still looking for people. Or you can go to these websites here. We have powerthepolls.org, where you can learn more information. NASS.org/Can I vote? Become a poll worker, and I'll have all of these links down below. And of course, the EAC.gov means it is an official government website, /voters/become poll worker. So you can go there and learn more about becoming a poll worker in your state. And like I said, I loved working for King County. It was a lot of fun, and it was really cool to see like the same people coming back every cycle. It was kind of like summer camp. So it's like, hey, I haven't seen you in like 4 or 5 months. How you doing? I really enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun being part of the democratic process. So if this is something that interests you, I really highly encourage you to go out there and do it. And if you have any other questions about working from home, self-employment, or voting scams, come on over to workathomefaq.com/ask. Fill out the form. Let me know what you want to know. And of course, if you want to learn more about working from home, mystery shopping, self-employment, all of that, go to workathomefaq.com/learn. There'll be links to my books and programs and everything you wanted to know. Again, my name is Bethany. I do not know everything, but I do know a lot of things, and I'm happy to help you out. Don't forget to follow, like, share, and subscribe. I am on the Facebook, the LinkedIn, the Twitter, the YouTube, the Instagram, the Pinterest, and whatever will come next. Thanks a lot for stopping by. I'll see you next time.